Welcome back to HeroQuest, where our barbarian elf, dwarf, and wizard are trying to find an evil gargoyle somewhere in the dungeon and take it out. That is the mission. Alright, so we left it off last time. Our barbarian is right in front of the door. We positioned ourselves to our advantage. And of course, the barbarian is up. So let's roll for his movement, see how far he can go. Wow, he can move 3 spaces. I guess he's just sitting at the door and not moving very far, but he is going to open the door. So we will snap open the door. And of course, when we do that, we need to go to the program and see what is revealed in the room. So we're using the HeroQuest Game Master freeware program to have the computer play the part of Zargon. So we can do this completely cooperatively or solo, as I'm doing here. So let's go and see what the program has to say. All right, so we have the barbarian here, and he is going to pop open this door. Oh, we don't want to remove the player. We want to open the door. There we go. Reveal this location. Okay. This mummy is the guardian of Falmarg's tomb and was once a mighty warrior. It rolls 4 dice instead of 3 when it attacks. Oh, great. And it has 2 body points. Oh, and it's not alone as well. It also has a couple of zombies with it. This can be a problem. Wow, and if the barbarian moves in 1 step, then he blocks everyone else from getting in the room. What do we want to do? And the zombies attack with 3 and are 2 attack dice. And of course the wizard is saying, this was a bad idea. We should have just gone to this giant room, which was probably the finale and where the gargoyle is hiding. Well, I don't think we're going to move our barbarian because he will block everybody else unless he moves up here. But then these guys are just going to come right through and attack us. So this is very bad. We're going to go to the next player, which is going to be the elf. He's not going to do anything. The dwarf is not going to do anything. We come to the wizard. Now we're going to go back to the table. We're going to look at his spells and see if there's a spell that makes sense for him to cast. Otherwise, we're just going to come back here and see what Zargon is going to do to us, which will probably be unpleasant. All right, we are in a world of pain. Let's take a look at the mummy, and we will look at the zombie. All right, so, and I hope this is going to focus for us. So here's the mummy. Of course, he gets that extra attack because he's the guardian of the tomb. 2 body points, 2 defense, or 4 defense dice, 3 attack, which is 4 attack, I believe, and can move 4 squares. So he can't move very quickly, but hits pretty darn hard. And zombies, the first time we've seen them in the game. And again, I don't know how this is focusing. I hope it is. They can move 5. They have 2 attack dice, 3 defense, and only 1 body point. Okay, that's the critters in the tomb here. This is, wow, this is not good. And I can't remember if there was a door in that room at the backside or not. We'll take a look when we go back there. All right, the wizard is indeed going to cast a spell. He's going to cast Veil of Mist on the dwarf. It says the spell may be cast on any one hero, including yourself. And I believe it's just line of sight, so he's not going to have to move. He just can see the dwarf directly beside him. And on a hero's next move, so next time the dwarf goes, he may move unseen through spaces that are occupied by monsters. So basically he can move through spaces that are occupied by monsters. And that's really the reason I wanted to use that. So we're going to have the barbarian stay at the door and deal with what he has to deal with. At least the dwarf then can move through the barbarian and move through the monsters and get into that room and help in the battle. Okay. So that was, that was the wizard's turn. Cast the spell back to the computer program, and we'll see what these evil guys are going to do to us.
Oh, right. This was a bad idea. So the wizard has cast the spell on the dwarf, which means he's going to be able to move through monsters next turn. But now it is Zargon's turn. Let's see what he's going to do. Okay. Oh, yeah, right. And he hits us with 2. We're going to continue here, because once he moves, then he can no longer move again. So he hit the barbarian for 2 attacks. Okay. We'll deal with that. I'm going to keep going, and Oh, and he's not even moving anything else. So he basically just moved one of the zombies up here and smacked onto our barbarian for two hits. So let's go back to the table, roll some dice, and see if we can avoid all or at least some of that damage. Oh, we are so in a world of hurt. Okay, so this zombie here passed through the mummy guardian, and I don't want to knock everything over here. Got right in up into the barbarian's grill and hit, rolled two hits. Now the barbarian has two dice to defend with, and let's hope he can get a couple successes on defending. He got one. Well, okay, that's better than none. So he's going to take one damage. He's going to knock him down to 5 hit points. We're in pretty good trouble here. All right, so the barbarian is up next. He, of course, has a zombie right in his face, and he gets to roll 3 dice for the attack. Come on, we really need some major league smackage to happen right here. And he gets one hit. Isn't that not good? Now, they only have one body point, so one hit. If it gets no defense, we're going to be able to kill it. So let's go to the program and see if we can take it out at least.
Okay, so we've had the barbarian hit this guy once, but we're going to see what happens. Oh, great. He does not defend at all. We got so lucky. So we do one damage and we take him out. And of course, I didn't roll for the barbarian's movement. And oh, what do I want to do with that? I actually think we are going to move the barbarian one space. Sounds a little crazy, but I think we're going to do it. Up next is going to be our elf, and I think we're going to put the elf down here and attack this zombie, but we have to go roll dice and see if he can. So here's the plan. We're going to try to move him here. That would be 1, 2, 3. The only way he can't do that is if he rolls snake eyes. So we're going to do that because we're going to have to roll some attack dice. We have to roll movement and attack. So let's go and do that. Okay, so our barbarian did what he needed to do. He took down this zombie, which, wow, was very fortunate. And now we are going to have the elf roll to move. So let's see what he gets for movement. Oh, and our barbarian moved in one space after it took the space of the zombie it killed. And our elf is trying to move. Oh, yeah, 9. Lots of movement. We're going to move him right in here, and he's going to attack this zombie. It's 2 dice to attack with. Come on, elf. Gets one hit. Okay, same thing again. Back to the program. Let's see if we can take down that zombie.
Okay, here we go. So we did manage to get our elf in here, attacking this guy, and he does get his defense. Unfortunate. So we don't do any damage to him. Up next, of course, is the dwarf. And unfortunately, we kind of wasted that spell on the dwarf, which is not good. So we're going to try to get the dwarf 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces here. So we're going to have to roll to 4. Oops, of course, it's his turn now. We're going to have to roll at least a 4, and we're going to try and attack the main dude. And what did we say against him? He's got attack and defense of 4 each. Ouch, we got to take this guy down. 2 body points. All right, let's go and have our dwarf try to move there. He needs 4 movement points. And then, yeah, then we're going to see what happens.
Okay, and the excitement continues, I guess. So we didn't take him out, darn it. But, oh, we got to roll for the dwarf because we have to see how far he can move. And he can move 7. So, yep, he has enough movement to get where we wanted him to be, which is, or do we want him to be this side? 4 of us. Yeah, you know what? I think we're actually going to come. No, we're going to leave the dwarf there. We're going to leave the dwarf there because we have a plan, I think. All right, dwarf is there. He is attacking this mummy, which has a ton of defense. Wow, this is a bad situation. Okay, dwarf, do your stuff. The dwarf does nothing. He misses completely. And that's pretty much useless. So let's just go right into the wizard. Wizard's going to roll to move. Wizard gets 7. We're going to move the wizard into this room, onto this corner. So I'm going to turn this door around so we can get our models in here a little easier. So the door's there. Wizard's going to move here.
The wizard has a dagger, but he is diagonal, and he cannot use it in a diagonal attack. However, he can throw it, but then he will have nothing left to attack with. And it only does one attack die for throwing. Well, let's hold off on that for now. But I don't know if he wants to cast another spell. Wow, this is just so unfortunate. I mean, he can cast sleep. Okay. I think we may actually cast sleep on the mummy. Of course, and for the bottom, may not be cast against mummies, zombies, or skeletons. Let's forget that. All right. Unfortunately, we're up to Zargon's turn, and I think he's going to be bringing the pain. Okay, this is a bad situation. So our dwarf missed the mummy completely, and up next is our wizard, who is moving here and doing nothing. And now let's see. Oh, there is a door there. I keep forgetting. I'll put that in when we get back to the table. Up next is Zargon. Okay. Only two hits against the barbarian with four dice. So that's not terrible. So let's remember that. Two hits against the barbarian. I want to do everything here first. And we keep going. The mummy moves away. And the zombie attacks the elf for one hit. And moves away. Okay. So then they backed up one. So mummy hit barbarian for two. Zombie hit elf for one. They both backed away. Let's go to the table, roll some defense dice. Okay, there better be some awesome treasure in this room afterwards. So the mummy hit our barbarian for two and backed up. The zombie hit the elf for one and backed up. So I'm just going to get everything moved into position first. And now we're going to roll some defense dice. Two defense dice for our barbarian. Come on, we don't want him to lose too many more hit points. And he rolls two of the defense dice for the monsters, so he takes two hits. That is very unfortunate. That puts him down to three hit points. We are in a world of trouble. Bad, bad trouble. Okay, the elf took one hit. He also has two defense dice. Come on, block it. And he blocks one, so he takes none. So that's good. So as a recap, our barbarian only has three hit points left, our elf four, dwarf five, and now the Veil of Mist spell is going to wear off. So that was kind of a wasted spell, but there it is. And our wizard has four hit points. So once again, we are in some pretty bad trouble. But our barbarian goes next. And is he just going to, he's just going to step up to the plate right here in front of this mummy. And he's going to roll three, come on, three dice to try to hit him with. And he gets two hits. So that is excellent. Let's go to the program and see if those two hits are going to land. I hope they do. Okay, our barbarian moves up here and attacks the mummy, for two hits. And what does he do? Come on, nothing, nothing. Oh, he gets one. Oh, too bad. Does one damage, still alive. Up next, of course, we have the elf, and he can, I wonder if we should concentrate on this guy. But then if we do, it leaves the wizard open to get beat on, or does it? No, it doesn't. We're going to move the, well, we're going to try to do this. One, two, three, four, four. To here and attack the mummy. So let's try that. Yeah, we're going to try that. Moving four, and he's going to attack the mummy. Let's go back to the table. All right, the mummy obviously posing our biggest threat. Come on, we need a four or higher on movement for the elf, or I have to rethink things. He gets six. Okay, that's good. So our elf can get into position over here. You can move through your own friendly models. Attacking the mummy. Come on, we need a couple of smackages right here. Come on, elf. The short sword gets one hit. Okay, well, that might be enough. The mummy now only has one hit point left. We hit him for one. Let's go back to the program. Okay, and a funny feeling he's going to block it, but we hit him for one. And he blocks it. Oh, you rotten guy. All right, up next is going to be, of course, our dwarf. The dwarf's going to go 1, 2, 3, we hope, and try and hit the mummy back to the table for some more dice rolling.
Yeah, situation's getting too tense for me. All right, the dwarf. Oh, we got to roll for movement. He should be able to get 3 if he rolls snake eyes. Then he's going to come over and attack the zombie instead. But he rolls a 4, which is certainly enough. That was, yes, it was in camera, to get where he needs to go, which is the backside of the mummy. Okay, 2 attack dice. Come on, we really, really, really need to take this guy down because his attack of 4 dice is just too painful. 1 skull again. Ah, boy. I have a feeling he's going to be able to block it, but maybe not. 1 skull attack. Let's go and see what happens.
All right, if we ever needed this mummy to blow his defense roll, now would be the time. 1 attack only, and he misses. Oh wow, we are so lucky. And with that, a mummy is toast. Oh wow, okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have our magic user is going to go 1, 2, 3. I'm assuming he's going to be able to roll a 3, but I guess we're going to have to go to the table, because if he can't roll a 3, then this guy 1, 2, 3, 4 can probably get to him. So yeah, we're gonna have to go to the table first, roll our wizard's movement, and then it'll be Zargon's turn.
Okay, so unreal. We finally took the mummy guardian down. That was a tough battle. We have to see if our wizard is able to roll a 3. Oh yeah, he rolls a 4, so no problem. 1, 2, 3, no problem. Wow. And now, of course, it is Zargon's turn. He still has that one annoying mummy left. And yes, I kept saying I'm going to put the door in here, and I keep forgetting because there is a door here. So we've been so busy fighting, we haven't really been looking at the doors. Time now for that zombie to go. And yeah, I have a feeling he's going to attack the barbarian, but I have no idea. Let's go find out. All right, so our wizard did manage to get here. All right, Zargon's turn, and let's see what he does. Oh, he attacks the elf. Okay, and of course hits him twice. All right, we're gonna have so he moved, so he's not gonna move, so we're just gonna say yes. Okay, so what's happened is the elf has been hit twice. That's unfortunate. We're gonna have to go back to the table and hope that we can defend at least one of those.
All right, well, this pesky little zombie shambled right up into the elf's face. I'll leave him this way so I can fit him in here. Smacked on her elf twice. Our elf only has 4 hit points. This is bad. And we're going to roll some defense. Come on. He rolls no defense at all, which means our elf now has smacked down to 2 hit points. That is very unfortunate. Wow, we are being beaten down. Of course, it's our turn now, though. So up next is the barbarian. The barbarian has had quite enough of this pesky zombie's attacks, and he's going to do his broadsword attack, and he gets 1 hit. Oh boy. All right, back to the program. Let's see if that 1 hit is enough.
Okay, our barbarian does 1 hit to the zombie, and the zombie cannot defend it and is taken out. Oh boy. And back to the table. I think what I'm not going to do is I'm not going to keep rolling to move, because with no monsters anywhere left in the dungeon, these guys can basically go where they want now, get positioned. But we may want to have the dwarf search for treasures, I think. So we're just going to leave the barbarian there. The elf is down to 2 hit points. We're not going to have him search. We are going to have the dwarf search. Now, I'm going to use the program here to search, because there might be something special in this room, because, I mean, there was a mummy in here, unless it's the next room over past this door that's the tomb. Maybe this is the tomb. I don't know. But we're going to do a search here. We're going to do a search anyway. So if this is just a general search, we're going to pull a card off of our card deck. If it's a special search, then we will know. So we're going to go up here to search for treasure. Pick a hazard card. Pick a hazard card. Well, it's a special. I guess we're going to have to go through the deck till we get a hazard card. Man,
That's awful. Okay. We're going to have to pick a hazard card. All right, back to the table. And yeah, we get beat on with a hazard. And then I think we're going to position ourselves somewhere and call this an episode. All right, well, we managed to take out the zombie. Of course, we went to the elf's turn. He didn't do anything. Now, the dwarf. Oh, this is lame. So we're going to go through this deck till we get a hazard. And so we're just going to keep flipping them over till we get a hazard. The first one we get is a gem, so that's of no use. The next one we get is jewels. Oh man, that would have been good. The next one is a hazard. Damn it. Okay, so we had to pick a hazard card because that's what it said. What do we get? Suddenly. Yeah, of course. This is the dwarf, man. He's not going to fall. Anyway. Suddenly, the stone beneath your feet gives way. You fall into a shallow hole, losing one body point and ending your turn. You may climb out and move normally on your next turn. Turn this card to the bottom of the deck. Well, that sucks. Heavily. Okay, so basically all that happened was our dwarf loses a hit point. He goes from 5 down to 4. Now we have a decision to make. Wow, do we want to press on and open this door? I'm assuming that's the tomb. This must have been the antechamber to the tomb. We still have a room here with a closed door that we haven't gone into. Man, but I don't know if we should just call it a day and get ready for the big fight, because everyone's beaten down pretty badly. This is so horrible, because we're right at the tomb door, but I have a feeling I'm going to open that tomb door, and there's going to be another 2 mummies and 3 skeletons, and we just don't have the hit points left, or the spells left, to deal with it. So I'm going to reposition the camera. I'm not going to roll and move for every character, because that's just going to take 100 hours. We're not doing any more searching. We did the one search here. I don't think we're going to go into the tomb door. It's just, we just don't have the hit points. So I'm going to reposition the camera. We're going to get set up for our final episode because I'm pretty 100% convinced that the big room is going to be the final showdown. So let me reposition the camera. We're going to get our guys set up, and that's going to be it. I'll give you a recap of the spells and where everyone's hit points are. And next episode will be the finale. All right, so after much discussion of what they want to do, they've set themselves up this way in front of the big room. Like I said, I'm 99.3% convinced that is the final showdown room. We have the unopened door. We put the barbarian directly in front of the door. He only has 3 hit points, so he's not in the greatest of shape. We're going to put the dwarf just to the north of the barbarian. He has 4 hit points. We have our wizard down south here with his bunch of spells, and we'll look at them in a second. He has 4 hit points, and we have the elf with only 2 hit points and 1 spell. So let's start with the elf. He has 2 hit points, 1 spell. He has pass through rock spell. And you can cast this on any hero, including yourself, which he may cast it on himself, and you can basically walk through walls on your next move. He may move through any walls, so he can move as far as he rolls his dice. So he basically can walk through walls and furniture, I believe, as well. Move through walls on his next turn. You can walk through anything. You basically phase through. So that's his 1 spell left. Now we're going to take a look at the wizard. So he has a bunch of spells left, which we're going to have to use. He has sleep, and this spell puts a monster into deep sleep, so it can't move, attack, or defend itself. The spell can be broken at once or on a future turn by a monster rolling 1 red die for each of its mind points. If a 6 is rolled, the spell... So this is nice. If we can put something to sleep, and it doesn't immediately roll a 6... that's not a mummy, zombie, or skeleton. We can hit it, and it cannot roll any defense because it can't defend itself. So we might be able to one-shot a really nasty thing. We have Swift Wind, which means on the next turn, a player can roll 4 red dice for movement instead of 2. Genie. And we're going to have to use this one for some smackdown. This spell conjures a genie. It can do one of the following. Can open any door on the board. Or... use 5 combat dice to attack a monster within your line of sight. I'm pretty sure we need the wizard to use this to beat on the gargoyle. We have Courage, which is also another excellent spell. It can be used on a hero, including yourself. The next time the hero attacks, he rolls 2 extra combat dice. A spell is broken the moment the hero can no longer see a monster. So I think
Oh, man, if we cast it on the Barbarian, he gets 5 attack dice. If we cast on the Dwarf, he gets 4 attack dice. It might be better casting this on the Dwarf just because the Dwarf has more hit points. So we have Ball of Flame. Spell may be used on one monster enveloping a ball of fire. It'll inflict 2 body points of damage. A monster rolls two red dice on a 5 or 6. The damage is reduced by 1 point for each 5 or 6. So this is another good spell. So that's what the wizard's got left. And that's going to conclude this episode. So thanks so much for watching along. Thanks for liking my videos. A thumbs up if you do. I really appreciate it. And also thanks for all the subscriptions. And I hope you're enjoying this. Of course, this is the ancient Jurassic Park game from, long, long ago, 1989, HeroQuest. It's still pretty fun. It's a roll and move, but at least you get to roll 2 dice to move instead of 1. And, it's a bit simplistic. It's not Descent. It's not any of the more modern board games, but it's still kind of a fun 3D environment dungeon crawl. That doesn't take forever to play, and just generally is a lot of fun. So thanks so much for watching along. Join me next time for the conclusion to HeroQuest The Trial. Are our 4 heroes going to be beaten up and killed, or will they manage to take down the gargoyle? So thanks a lot, and we'll see you next time.